Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Today we are going to discuss a lot of questions that are there, of course. But first of all, let me inform you that you can download the PDF of this session via the link given in the description. So we have a Telegram channel where we share the PDFs of our YouTube sessions. So this PDF is also available there. If you want the PDF, you can download it from that channel. Apart from this, you should also know that the Telegram channel I'm talking about is also a discussion forum where you can share your doubt among the other students who are appearing for the same examination. So if you want to have a discussion kind of a thing on any kind of quant reasoning question or anything, then also you can benefit from that Telegram channel. Okay, so let's finish the talk about the Telegram channel and begin with our first question. Which country is supporting India Young Water Professional Program? Denmark, Norway, Netherlands, Australia, United Kingdom are in the options, out of which Australia is the right answer. So India and Australia, both of these countries have together launched this India Young Water Professional Program, which is nothing but a training program for the capacity building of the professionals working in the field of water. Okay, basically it is for promoting sustainable water and the conservation of water in India. That is the whole crux, whole idea behind launching this program. Now we are going to delve into the details of this program. So the very first thing that you should be aware of is that this program has been launched under the National Hydrology Project. Okay, so it's a mistyping here, it's hydrology. Okay, so this India Young Water Professional Program has been launched under the National Hydrology Project that is being run by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. Now, the basic purpose of this National Hydrology Project is to gather information about the water resources in India and strengthen the capacity of India so that the conservation of those resources can be done. So that is the basic idea of this National Hydrology Project. Now, in which year was this project approved or launched? This is your question that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Okay, so I have asked you the very first question. Now I can have my food digested completely. Now, coming back to this news. So this is the first edition of this program, clearly, because next edition would be launched on the basis of the success of this first phase. Now, purpose is to train the professionals working in the field of water with necessary skills to address the water needs of India. Very basic it is. I have told you in the beginning itself that it is the training program for the people working in the field of water. Now, do remember that it also aims to achieve the gender equality. How? So in the phase one, 20 participants will be selected, and out of these 20, 10 will be men, 10 will be women, because the authorities believe that if we want to sustain, if we want to use the water sustainably, and if we want to conserve the water resources for a sustainable use, for a futuristic use, then we need to have opinions from all walks of life or from all kinds of communities. Okay, so that also includes the women communities. Therefore, they are striving towards achieving the gender equality in the field of hydrology as well through this program. So training tools, how will they train? So online lectures, workshop, discussions, and many more things will be conducted under this India Young Water Professional Program. So this I have already told you. Now, during the National Hydrology Project's workshop on sustainable water management in November 2019, India and Australia agreed to launch this program. And right now we are seeing the launch of this program. So that was all about that program. Now let's move on to the next question. Which country organized the first international conference on hydrogen energy? India, South Korea, France, Philippines, Singapore. Now here the right answer is India. So India has organized this first international conference on hydrogen energy, and it has been organized by the Central Board of Irrigation and Power, with the support of Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Central Electricity Authority, NTPC. The venue is New Delhi. Apart from this, the sponsors of this conference were NHPC Limited, SGVNL, and Power Grid and THDC. So, as you can clearly see, all the organizers belong to India. So, this conference was purely organized by India for creating awareness about hydrogen energy and discussing ways to improve and explore more and more hydrogen energy. Moving on to the next question, where is world's tallest bridge pier being developed? Manipur, Bali, Jakarta, Mali, Manila. So the right answer here is Manipur. Okay, so in the state, in the Indian state of Manipur, Indian Railways is basically constructing the world's tallest bridge pier, which is a part of the Jiribam-Imphal railway project. So this bridge is basically a part of this railway project, which is completely in the state of Manipur. Okay, so this place is also in Manipur, and Imphal, we know, is the capital of the state. Moving on to the next question, which state has launched the Call Your Cop mobile app? So Andhra Pradesh, Nagaland, Assam, Odisha, Jharkhand are in the options. The right answer here is Nagaland. Now, the basic purpose of this application is to help the citizens who are in distress so that they can make a call to the police immediately. So that is the basic idea. Which is the first state in India to get certification for growing organic kiwis that are now ready for exports to other countries also? Sikkim, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Arunachal Pradesh. So here the right answer is Arunachal Pradesh. Now why is it in the news? Let me first tell you that the certification that for organic kiwis was given to Arunachal Pradesh last year only. Then why is it in the news right now? The reason is that these organic kiwis have been launched at the Adi Mahotsav, which was held in Dilli Haat in New Delhi. Okay, it's the national tribal festival which is annually held in the Dilli Haat, and here the organic kiwis from Arunachal Pradesh were launched, and they are basically now ready to be exported to other countries also. So do remember these facts. So only that is written here. Moving on to the next question, what is the GDP forecast for India for FY22 by Goldman Sachs? So as you can see here, many percentages are given, out of which 9.1% is the right answer. So for the current financial year of 2021 to 2022, the forecast by Goldman Sachs is 9.1 for India. The forecast in terms of CPI inflation, consumer price inflation, is 5.8% this year in comparison to 5.2% last year. Okay, this is FY21 and this is FY22. Who is the chairman of the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs? So we have Vivek Johri, Pranav Mahajan, D. Sampath Kumar, Fakre Alam, P. Haridasan Pillai. The right answer here is Vivek Johri. Which institute has signed an MOU with the Ministry of Civil Aviation to undertake research to study the effect of the regional connectivity scheme on commercial air travel in India? So first of all, this regional connectivity scheme that is mentioned here is UDAN, Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. Now which institution is it? It is Indian School of Business, located in Hyderabad. So this institution has signed this MOU with Ministry of Civil Aviation so that this institution can conduct a study on the impact that is created by this RCS UDAN scheme. This also includes the social impact, okay? Not only the commercial air travel impact, but it also includes, it also has a dimension on the social impact of this scheme. When will NASA launch its investigation of convective updraft mission? So we have the many years, out of which 2027 is the right answer. Now, basically, this mission is going to study the storms, the tropical storms and cyclones, and its impact on weather. That is the whole idea behind launching this mission. So first of all, understand that it will be a group of three satellites that will be launched in the low Earth orbit, and from there these satellites will monitor the behavior of the tropical storms and thunderstorms, including their impact on the weather and climate models. Okay, now this mission is part of the NASA's Earth Venture program, basically the third edition of this Earth Venture program. Now, what is this Earth Venture program of NASA? So this program, basically in all its editions, the basic overarching theme of this Earth Venture program was to explore the science behind the Earth's phenomenon, behind the weather and atmospheric phenomenon. And in order to understand that, this Earth Venture program undertakes many projects like this one. Okay. So that is the whole idea behind this Earth Venture program, and this is a part of this Earth Venture program. Moving on to the next question, which bank has launched Trade Emerge online platform to offer comprehensive digital banking and value added services to exporters and importers across India? So here the right answer is ICICI Bank. So this is a very basic question, guys. Nothing much to remember here. Just remember ICICI Bank and this Trade Emerge online platform. Both of these are the keywords here. Okay, so if you remember these two words only, you can easily make the entire story up in your mind that this Trade Emerge basically is the online platform that is going to boost the trade so that the trade can be emerged. So which trade is this platform going to boost? Export import trade. Okay, so keywords are these only: ICICI Bank and Trade Emerge. So here this video ends. Guys, if you liked the content provided by us, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video.